Fridays mean Unplugged on 702.
And indeed they do. It's time for 702 Unplugged. And today we feature talented violinist, and that is Davina May Gordon. And she has fused her passions, classical music, classical instrument like the violin, with, of course, her love for hip hop and pop culture. She's built quite a following over the years with hashtag Davina Plays. And she's graced a number of stages and is set to do so yet again, as part of being part of the lineup for the Unlaunch series. And she will be in great company, and she's our Unplugged guest today. Hi, Davina, how are you?
Hey, Azania, I'm good. How are you?
I'm very well. The last time we spoke, you and your partner, Donovan Goliath, had created these interesting pieces of work on Instagram that had everybody talking while everyone was down in the doldrums about being locked up. You guys got all creative.
I was just thinking about that. That seemed like a lifetime ago, you know.
It does, right?
It does. A lifetime ago, and it was this year.
Just a mere few months ago. Yeah. So what is the Unlaunch series all about? You'll be with Ami Faku, Tamara Day.
Sun
Owl musician.
Yeah, it's a wonderful launch, or unlaunch, I should say, of the VW T-Rock. And there's going to be a fantastic event happening at Melrose Arch that will include music, entertainment, food, test drives, giant installations, and a lot more. So, yeah, everyone should check it out.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Yet another stage for you. But let's look at your career and how you've kind of steadily built it to get to this point where you're fusing your interest, as I was saying earlier on, because you have a deep love for classical music. But at some point, it seemed like you couldn't bring all of your music love, which is also hip hop, to it. But you found a way.
I absolutely did. And I had to force myself into it because, you know, I'd been playing in the orchestras in Joburg and actually in Cape Town as well. And I found myself feeling a bit stuck, you know, because it was the same routine over and over. And I started getting really sort of agitated and itchy fingers, if I can say that, because I felt like there wasn't a new wave of audience members that were coming into the concert hall. And I found that what I'm doing now allows people to see a different side of the instrument. You know, you think of the violin, it's only suited for a type of crowd or a type of genre. And this has really kind of given me a second win in my love for the instrument, you know, and I've converted so many people. So yeah, it's a lot of fun seeing people's reactions when I whip out my instrument and I play a certain tune that they recognize. And it's such a nice thing for me to see, because I'm just like, yeah, this is what I'm doing with the instrument.
And that's what you'll be doing this afternoon as well, because you're giving us all those hits. I saw Finesse by Bruno Mars. I love that album and that song as well. So I love it. And then what else did you include in your cover section?
So I start with Feels by Calvin Harris, featuring Pharrell. And then I end off with a really popular local tune called Shesha Geza. So yeah, that's always a big hit.
Showing your street cred. But you also teach, which I think is lovely. It's wonderful. Is it children that you teach, or is it just anybody who wants to learn how to play the violin?
It's mainly children at a primary school level, because it's best to start the instrument when you're really young. You know, you can still manipulate your muscles and, you know, train yourself to kind of position things a certain way. Whereas when you're bigger, all of your muscles will have been developed. So it's a little bit more awkward. But I must say this year was quite a challenging year with my teaching, because a lot of it was spent online, you know, and when you teach a practical instrument like the violin, where it's very hands-on, you know, lots of explaining and being really descriptive in what the kids have to do. Doing that all online was was not fun for the first few months, I have to say. But I think the kids also found their rhythm, and so did I. And now we've made it through the year. So
yes, it's no, we're all compelled to. We've all had to, whatever
we've had to adapt, stumbling you know? Blocks,
we've all have had to adapt. Absolutely. I remember whenever I think of you, of course, I think of not just your partner, Donovan, but your sister as well, Marcel, yes. Marcel Gordon, yes. who's an ENCA.
We're everywhere.
She is. So that's wonderful that you have this kind of support around you. But I also think of, was it 6 years ago? 6 years ago when you played and you opened for Kanye West.
It was in 2006. It was a little over 6 years ago, actually.
Oh, that's not long. No, I was measuring. Ago. I was actually thinking of a friendship that I have and trying to gauge.
I think that was his second trip to SA. I actually played when he first came to SA, when he toured the Touch the Sky tour. And I was still studying at the time, in fact. And I had bought a ticket to go to his concert at the Bellville Velodrome in Cape Town, when it was still called the Bellville Velodrome. Golden Circle tickets. A friend called me up and said, "What are you doing on this date?" And I said, no, I can't work. I'm going to go see Kanye, you know. And then his next sentence was just, "Well, how would you like to be part of Kanye's concert?" And then I think I just blacked out for a second. Dropped the phone. So that was a really surreal experience. I still think about it all the time. You know, I have kind of vague flashbacks of that night because the concert, the night that he performed, was the first time we saw him. So he didn't come to any of the rehearsals that we had. So there's me sitting on stage playing and Kanye West is a few feet away from me. It was really
and having
surreal.
To negotiate all the different emotions, you know, focus. But no, we're so excited.
Too much.
Focus. Isn't it? Let's get to the music and let everybody experience how you fuse these two sounds together. And all of the best with the Unlaunch series.
Thanks. It will be my first live performance in almost 9 months. So I'm having a bit of a moment, but I'm very, very excited about it.
Yeah. As they say, I'm sure it's like riding a bike. Your muscle is already trained. It just needs a little bit of reminding. So. Thank you so much.
I hope so. Thanks
Davina for having me. There, featured on today's 702 Unplugged in a recorded performance.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to my live on 702. The first track I will be playing is a song called Feels by Calvin Harris and Pharrell. And I think Katy Perry is in it as well. And I hope you enjoy it. I always have so much fun jamming along to this one.
Thank you.
Okay, so the next one is a really fun one to jam to as well. It's a Bruno Mars track featuring Cardi B. It's Finesse. And of course, I had to close with a real summer banger. It's a song called Shesha Geza by De Mtuda and Angelic. Enjoy! Thank you.
mean unplugged on 702.